Hey gang, it's Chris with Ecoustics, and I'm here with the Hisense 116UX. It's the 116-inch RGB backlit LED LCD TV, and it's here. We saw it at CES, weren't sure when it was going to be coming, but this week it went up for pre-sale at Best Buy, and Hisense is showing it off here in a showcase in New York City for reviewers and tech journalists such as myself. So I'll give you some of the details on it and what I've been able to see so far. So the big news on the 116UX is that it features an all-new RGB LED backlighting system, which is capable of actually 95% of the BT2020 color space, which is really unheard of in LED LCD TVs. It's quite a high bandwidth color reproduction, and that's thanks to the new RGB backlights. So there's separate subpixels lighting elements for both red and green, and also blue. So all three of the primary colors. What you won't see on this TV is actually quantum dots. It uses a standard color filter to create all of the colors in the visible spectrum. Again, up to 95% of BT2020. It's an anti-reflection pro panel, which I saw with the lights on. You can see some reflections of the floor and the wall and the lights, but it's subdued. So you can still get pretty good black levels, even in a bright room like this. Peak brightness measured up to 8,000 nits. That's in a 2% window. So, you know, not lighting up the full panel. You couldn't get that kind of brightness on a full panel. But 2% for specular highlights and star fields, you know, things where areas of the screen need to be super bright. This panel does extremely well. I put on some content with text on a black background and did see some amount of haloing around the bright images on a black background, and also the black background, like say in the Blade Runner opening credits. Wasn't quite as dark as the letterboxed areas at the top and bottom of the screen. So black levels are not really gonna match an OLED or a micro LED TV, but you ever try buying a 116-inch OLED TV? Well, that's right, you can't. The biggest you can get is about 97, 98 inches currently on OLED. So it's a 165 hertz native panel, which should be great for gaming. In fact, it has Dolby Vision gaming and HDR 10 Plus gaming. In addition to Dolby Vision IQ, Dolby Vision Gaming, as I mentioned, HDR10, HDR10+, HDR10+ Adaptive, and HLG, built in all these different high dynamic range formats, including the dynamic HDR. It's got Wi-Fi 6E. Of course, it's got a filmmaker mode that automatically detects content and puts itself in the most accurate mode based on that content coming in. And far-field voice control, which means the microphone is actually built into the TV, so you can use digital assistants or search for content using just your voice. The native panel is 165 hertz, as I mentioned, which is good for moving image reproduction. And the sound is actually kind of something special this year. It is a partnership with WLA, the French company. This system is said to be 6.2.2 channel. It does have speakers on the sides, and it has speakers on the top, which you can't see, up-firing speakers. And it's got two subwoofers built into the back. These are the subwoofers, as well as four speakers, I believe, in the bottom, which are down-firing as well. So you don't see any visible speakers. But I put on some Dolby Atmos content from like Dune and from Blade Runner, and it did sound pretty impressive for built-in speakers in the TV. So here it is, again, world's first RGB backlit LED LCD TV to hit the US market. The price is gonna be $29,999, so yeah, that's $30,000, and it's available to pre-order on Best Buy. So with RGB backlighting for an LED LCD TV, instead of having blue or white backlights and having to generate all of those colors with a color filter, TVs like this Hisense use a RGB backlight. That means they have separate subpixels for red, green, and blue, and that allows them to create a wider spectrum of colors more efficiently, actually. So even though it's 116-inch TV, it's not gonna like automatically like raise your power bills substantially. Of course, it is capable of peak brightness, which is gonna use a little bit of juice. But when compared to a traditional white or blue backlit TV with quantum dots, the light output is actually done much more efficiently. So that allows them to reach sizes of 116 inches without having excessive power usage. Take a look at the back as well. So you can see the inputs and outputs. It's actually got a handle in the back, one on each side. Makes it a little bit easier to move. There's your jack pack. Of course, it wouldn't be a TV review or showcase without the Spears and Munsell skin tone tests, which you can find on the UHD benchmark by Spears and Munsell. It's an excellent disc for testing out different displays, projectors, monitors, TVs, etc. May not be captured by the camera all that well, but you, I can see at least that the various skin tones of the lovely ladies on screen are very accurate in all their various shades from pink to brown. So there, I guess this is one of the aspects of an RGB backlit LCD TV is that it's able to create very accurate colors. And that is definitely welcome when you're watching colorful content or you're just trying to get, you know, that immersive, you are there kind of experience when watching a TV. The skin tones are kind of hard to reproduce, and when they're done poorly, they kind of bring you out of the moment. So it's good to see that the Hisense 116UX is doing a good job here. Even the remote control from the 116UX is pretty special. It's backlit, of course. You'd expect that in a high-end remote, but it's also got a little solar panel. So ambient room light will keep the battery of the remote charged. So you won't have to replace the batteries or charge it separately. There is a USB port if you want to charge it, like if you're having, you know, if you're not getting enough light, you've got it in a dark home theater and the batteries die, you can just charge it up with a USB cable. But it's a pretty cool looking remote. It's got all the things you would need on a remote, including that solar panel at the bottom. And shortcuts to all of the various streaming services, full navigation, a direct input button, which is nice. Some manufacturers have taken that off their remotes lately, which I don't like. So thumbs up on the remote. So there you have it. It's the Hisense 116UX RGB LED backlit LCD TV, and it is here for $30,000, available to pre-order on places like bestbuy.com. And Hisense reps tell me it'll be available for shipping probably later this month or early August. So if the race is on, then it looks like Hisense is gonna be first to the finish with an RGB LED backlit LCD TV. See you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye-bye.